off. On May 27th at Place des Arts, OMETS, which offers employment and social services to the Montreal community, will be hosting its annual gala. It's called A Chance to Shine, and it's really something great for the Montreal community. It's about raising funds necessary to support individuals and families as well who struggle with like daily challenges of poverty, neglect, hunger, addiction, abuse, learning disabilities, mental illness. And what's really terrific about these events is that 100% of the proceeds go towards helping children and youth at risk. And the Chance to Shine this year is going to feature a performance by Le Petit Cirque. It's an all-kids circus troupe from Los Angeles, and it was founded and directed by Quebec-born Nathalie-Yves Gaultier, and this group features the talents of prodigies aged 14 and under. Natalie's on the phone, and so is Kaylin Whaley, 12-year-old, 16-time world champion in karate. Welcome to both of you.
Hi, thank you.
Kaylin, are you there as well? Hey, there you are.
Yeah.
Natalie, I think I'm going to start with you. When did you start Le Petit Cirque?
Le Petit Cirque actually started in Los Angeles only about 3 years ago, but it's an offshoot of a program I had in Montreal for years and years called Kids in Action. And that was an inspirational theater place where kids would come and we would do all kinds of shows, musicals, but mostly things based on inspiration, humanity, doing good, being a better person. And then I moved out to Los Angeles and boom, that's... I took the show in the air, let's just say.
Nice. So just how talented are these kids?
Oh, my goodness. We'll put it this way. We have quite a few network televisions after us to have our own show right now.
No kidding.
We're kind of sitting pretty deciding. But these are kids that, what most people call child prodigies. And I thought, what happens if you go and select a bunch of prodigies and put them all in one stage? So you've got circus, acrobats, karate, singers, USA national dance champion, the rhythmic gymnastics champion. It's quite amazing.
So it's quite a sight and pretty dangerous, too, from what it sounds like.
Yes. Thank you. Finally, someone really gets it. It's absolutely high risk. And the fact that we're putting children up in the air 15 to 20 feet up over a stage raised by motors up and down. It's a stressful show, but we've never had an accident. And it's like Cirque du Soleil, but they're pint-sized, and there's a few more areas of arts thrown in there.
Let's bring in Kaylin, 12 years old.
Yeah.
Wow. It's pretty impressive that you're able to do stuff like this at such a young age. How did you end up joining the circus, Kaylin?
Well, I'm a 16-time world champion martial artist and a 5-time gold medalist at the U.S. martial arts team. And I just loved performing, and I loved to be on stage. And Le Petit Cirque seemed like a perfect fit for me. And so I decided to join, and it was probably the best choice I've ever made, and I love it.
The best choice you've ever made, and you're 12 years, so I'm glad to hear that. So how did you get into karate at a very young age, I guess?
Yeah. Well, I started martial arts when I was 4 years old because, believe it or not, I was very shy.
You were.
And, yeah, I was. And one day, my parents saw a sign, and it said confidence, discipline, and respect. So we decided to try it. And boom, that was it. It was my thing, and I have loved it, and I've been going ever since.
Well, you don't sound shy at all, and you sound extremely confident, which you have to be, I guess, when you're performing these kinds of... How dangerous is the kind of stuff that you do, Kaylin?
Well, it can be dangerous, but with a lot of practice, I've overcome the fear of, let's say, cutting myself with my sword, and I just go as hard as I can. And even though it can be dangerous, I love the thrill of it, and it's just very fun for me.
Boy, oh boy. And I'd love to hear just a little more of, like you said, when you were a kid, maybe a little shy, how long, once you got into karate, I guess it was once you started really becoming pretty good at it that you overcame your shyness and maybe became a little more confident?
Yeah. In my classes, we did something called public speaking. And through that, I had to, say my name and, my age and stuff like that. And through that, my shyness began to wear off. And now I'm confident I can perform in front of huge crowds and give speeches. And I have definitely overgrown my shyness.
That's amazing. What do you want to do when you grow up a little bit more?
Well, it would be great to be in movies, TV shows, and just I love performing. So something, if I could perform with my martial arts, that would be great.
Now let's bring Natalie back in. Natalie, who's the founder and director of this circus. Is Kaylin just an example of the kinds of kids who are involved? Because she's pretty special, obviously.
Yes, absolutely. You know, and also to add, she's got a 4-year-old little brother, Declan Whaley, is joining the ranks, and he just became national champion. So we've got him coming on a plane as well. So you've got basically a Cirque du Soleil extravaganza. You've got singers that are kids from OMET. Literally, we got about 8 teenagers from OMET that are going to sing. Yeah, incredible costumes designed by Lady Gaga's team out here.
Is that right?
And then you got the Karate Kid come out, and then, you know, all of a sudden you get this 4-year-old tiny little mite that comes out, national champion Declan with his sword. I mean, it's a sight, you know. You got kids in the air. You got the rhythmic gymnast. National champion as well. It's unbelievable to watch.
And what does it mean to you to be part of this cause, Natalie, as well?
It means a lot to me because my dream was always to come back home to Montreal and bring something special. I was a talent agent and launched Ryan Gosling and Alicia Cuthbert and Hayden Christensen and all these Canadian kids. And I said, one day I'm going to come back, not as an agent, but I'm going to come back with something amazing and do something for somebody. I converted to Judaism in 1997, so coming back home with a show is very powerful for me because I'm from Montreal. My dad, George, and Michelin live in Pierrefonds. My mom's on Nuns Island, Diane. I'm coming home with my Jewish roots of conversion and to do something for a cause that I really, really believe in. And when I met OMET, I just felt this is God's way. This is who is going to make all this magic happen, and I got to do some magic for them. I just adore that organization. They're unbelievable.
And Kaylin, have you ever been to Montreal before?
I have not, but I have been to Quebec, and I know Canada is an amazing country, and I can't wait to go back to Canada, and I can't wait to see Montreal and explore and perform there, actually. And I'm really excited to go there, not just to perform, but to actually see it and just have a lot of fun there.
I tell you, you've got some kind of head on your shoulders, and it sounds to me like you will be able to accomplish anything you put your mind to. Kaylin, it was a real treat speaking with you. And Natalie, likewise, thank you both for your time. Have a great show here in Montreal
thank
this month.
Thank you so much.
We're so excited.
And I know a lot of people are as well to see you. Natalie Gauthier, founder and director of Le Petit Cirque, as well as 12-year-old Kaylin Whaley. What a kid. As she said, a 16-time world champion in karate, 5-time gold medalist for Team USA in karate as well. Again, this show put on by Le Petit Cirque is happening on May 27th at Place des Arts. And if you're interested in finding some tickets, you can go to the OMET's website, OMETZ. OMETZ.ca/shine.
Let me tell you some of the reasons.